In this video, I just wanted to briefly discuss the difference between the capacity of a scale and the build of a scale. So you can see here I've got a small little bench scale, and the capacity of this scale is rated at 25 kilograms. So I might set up my indicator to reflect a 25 kilogram scale. And this is mostly just an arbitrary value that I've set the indicator, because the indicator doesn't necessarily know what we're going to hook up to it. So I have to tell the scale, you know what, this is going to be a 25 kg capacity, so that when we exceed this, you're going to show me an overload symbol on the display. Now, the actual load cell, however, that's in this scale is a 50 kilogram scale. So that makes the build of the scale a 50 kilogram build, but I've configured the indicator to be 25 kilograms. So that's really the big difference between capacity and build. Is capacity is that value that I've selected that's going to be the capacity of the scale, and I've configured the indicator to that particular value. It's important to make sure our capacity does not exceed our build, because then we would run into overloading problems. Now, this would apply also to, say, a large floor scale that has multiple load cells in it. Let's say I've got a 5,000 pound floor scale that has four load cells in it. Well, the capacity that I set my indicator up for might be 5,000 pounds. But I'll find in that floor scale that each of the four load cells in the corner are 2,500 pound load cells. And I have four of them. So 2,500 times four would be 10,000. So that's a 10,000 pound build for that 5,000 pound capacity floor scale. Now, I could set it up to be a 6,000 pound scale or a 7,500 pound scale. That's all fine too. The key is that we recognize that the capacity is nothing more than how I've configured my indicator to read that scale and that load cell in that system, and that the build is the sum of all of the load cells in the system and their rated capacities. So hopefully that helps you understand a little bit more about the difference between capacity and build, because the build is going to be something that comes up in calculations. And so you'll want to make sure that we're not using the capacity, but we're using the build. So we have to know the difference there.